Kim 130 students, we're ready now to talk about bond polarity, one of the last topics in Chapter 7, so we're almost finished. So, this is also a very important topic as it'll come up again in later chapters in this semester. So, bond polarity. A covalent bond can be polar or nonpolar. When the bond has electrons shared equally, it's called nonpolar. The electrons are equally between the two atoms, so there's no poles, there's no magnet, because it doesn't have a north or a south pole. So if it has no poles, it can't be a magnet. Now, a covalent bond where electrons are shared unequally is called polar. This means the electrons are closer to one of the atoms in the bond. So that makes that side a little more negative, and so it has a negative pole, and the other atom has a positive pole. So we have poles, that's like a magnet, a north and a south pole. So it's called polar. Now, to talk about polarity, we also have to go back and remember what electronegativity is, En. Electronegativity is the ability of a bonded atom to attract the electrons in that bond close to itself. Fluorine is the most electronegative element in the table. Elements are less electronegative the further away from fluorine they are, except for hydrogen. Hydrogen is about equal to carbon in electronegativity. Now, the noble gases do not have electronegativity values because they don't make bonds. So if you don't form a bond, you can't pull the bonded electrons close. So the noble gases don't have electronegativity values. That's why fluorine is the most electronegative. It's the most up and to the right element in the table. So fluorine is the most electronegative atom, pulling electrons close. The closer you are to fluorine, the better you are at pulling those bonded electrons close to you. So electronegativity again increases, as I said, as we move up the table and to the right, except the noble gases don't play this game. Molecules with two identical atoms always form a nonpolar bond, like an H to H bond, an I to I bond, a Cl to Cl bond. When you're bonded to yourself, you're nonpolar bond. So nonpolar bonds can also occur between different atoms that have same electronegativity values. For example, C and H also are considered nonpolar. So basically, if you're bonded to yourself, you're nonpolar, or if you're CH, you're nonpolar. Now, polar covalent bonds are between two different nonmetals. So one of the nonmetals is closer to fluorine and pulls the electrons closer. So we have a polar covalent bond. For example, C to O, H to Cl, S to F, Si to N are all two different nonmetals, so those are polar covalent bonds. This chart's very useful. Let's look at polar first. Polar bond, example, X to Z, two different nonmetals. The electrons are shared unequally because we have two different nonmetals. Whoever's closer to fluorine pulls the electrons closer. Electrons are negative, so that side is a little bit negative, represented by the Greek delta symbol. The other atom is, of course, a little bit positive then. So we have two poles, a negative and a positive pole, like a magnet, so polar for the poles. Now, nonpolar bonds are bonded to themselves, X to X. The electrons get shared equally because it's like a tug of war. If you're having a tug of war with yourself, there's no win, it's a tie. The electrons are right in the middle of the two atoms. So the electrons are shared equally. So again, if you're bonded to yourself, the tug of war for the electrons is a tie and there's no poles. No one's pulling the electrons closer. They're stuck in the middle. So no poles, nonpolar. Back to polar bonds. Someone's winning the tug of war. whoever's closest to fluorine is winning the tug of war and pulling those electrons closer. So think of it as a tug of war. Symbols used to indicate polarity. The delta plus indicates the partially or little bit positive atom. The delta minus indicates the partially negative atom. We can also use a polarity arrow pointing towards the more electronegative atom. That's the one closer to fluorine. So if you look at these examples here, we have a CF bond. F is closer to F, so it's a little bit negative. C's a little bit positive, and the arrow points towards the F. Now look at the middle one, the OH bond. Who's closer to fluorine, O or H? O is right next to F. So O is closer to F, so O pulls the electrons closer. It's a little bit negative. H is a little bit positive. The arrow points towards the O. And then the last one is PCl. Who's closer to fluorine, P or Cl? The Cl is. So Cl pulls the electrons closer. So Cl's a little bit negative. P's a little bit plus. The arrow points towards the Cl. Check. Noble gases don't have an electronegativity value. Why not? Why don't they pull bonded electrons close? Do you know? Hopefully you said. Electronegativity is the ability of an atom to pull bonded electrons close, but noble gases don't bond, so they don't have bonded electrons, so they can't pull the bonded electrons close because they don't have any. So what is the atom with the highest electronegativity again? Fluorine, right? Fluorine is the most electronegative atom. Yes, fluorine is a hog. It pulls electrons closer than anything else. No one pulls electrons closer than fluorine. All right, example questions. Let's add deltas and arrows to these five bonds. I want you to hit pause, write these bonds on a piece of paper, draw the little delta plus, delta minus above the bond, draw the arrow below the bond, just like I did a couple of slides ago. Okay, hit pause. Do this on your own. All right, we're back. So the CO bond, who is closer to fluorine out of C and O? O. So O's a little negative, C's a little positive, the arrow points towards the O. Good job. And F, who's closer to F? F is. So F is a little negative, N is a little positive, the arrow points towards the F. OH, who's closer to fluorine, O or H? O, yeah, so O's a little negative, H is a little positive, the arrow points towards the O. What about Cl and C? Yeah, Cl is closer to fluorine. It's right under it, just one step away. Carbon is three squares away. So chlorine's closer. Cl gets the little bit negative. C is a little bit positive. The arrow points towards the chlorine. Finally, Hc. Who's closer to F? That's a trick question. They're the same. C and H are nonpolar, so there is no deltas or arrow. Leave it blank. It's nonpolar. All right, next question. Are these bonds ionic, polar covalent, or nonpolar covalent? Br to itself, Br, Br. Nonpolar. Remember, you're nonpolar if you're bonded to yourself or CH and you're covalent. So that is nonpolar covalent. P to F. Polar covalent. Na to Cl. That has a metal. Yeah, so it's ionic. It's ionic. It has a metal and a non-metal, so it's ionic. F to Br. Yeah, that's polar covalent. All right, good job. Polarity review. Again, polarity is very important. We're going to talk about this over and over again in other chapters. Think of it as a tug of war for bonded electrons. The more electronegative atom, who's ever closest to fluorine, pulls the electrons closer and wins the tug of war. Because electrons are negative, that makes that atom a little bit negative, represented with the delta minus. By default, the other atom is a little bit positive, delta plus. Thus, the bond has two poles, so it's polar. If the atoms have the same electronegativity, like bonded to yourself or CH, then it's a tie. No one wins the tug of war, and it's nonpolar. All right, I hope that helps, GCC. Good luck. Catch you later.